What is up? Welcome back to my channel. It has been, I don't even know how long since I filmed a video, like 3 weeks, 4 weeks, something like that. I don't know, something disgraceful, but I feel like being on lockdown, there's not much to film. Like, if you want to see my day, they all resemble each other. Like, they all look the same. But I thought I'd take you through a little day of what it's like to be 32 weeks pregnant and not be able to leave your house, which isn't half bad because you're too tired to anyways. So it is, I think it's like noon right now. I walked this morning, just ate, and I have made a disaster of my childhood room, my childhood brother's room, and my other childhood brother's room, and my mother is probably going to kill me. She's actually already killed me multiple times, but it is so difficult to have bought a condo during all of this and can't go shopping anywhere. Like, I can't leave to go anywhere. So we bought a couch online that's not here yet, and we have a bed, and that's about it. Oh, and we have some chairs. So all of my stuff is kind of everywhere, but yeah. So right now I'm gonna go through and like organize the baby's clothes that we have so far, and see like how much we have of certain things. My mom's gonna kind of help me figure out like, oh, you need more of this, or too many onesies, or, you know. Exhibit A of disasters. Sorry. Onesie that I bought him. Actually, yeah, I bought this before I knew if it was a boy or a girl. And if you follow me on Instagram, or if you know me in person, I have an obsession with yellow and with bumblebees. And if this isn't the cutest thing, and his mom, and I think his family, Justin's mom and family, always like referred to Justin as a polar bear growing up because he's big, he hibernates, and he's white. And I thought these looked like little polar bears. It's probably more like Pooh Bear, but I don't know. It's just weird to think that like I bought this in October probably, and he'll be, well, this is 12 to 18 months, so he won't wear this for a while, but it's just crazy to think that like less than 2 months I'm gonna have a human to keep alive. I barely even know how to keep myself alive. So make sure you stay tuned to figure out how I figure out keeping a human alive. Yeah. All right, so I kind of went through, these are the only two newborn onesies that I have. Justin was 9'6" when he was born, like 9 pounds, 6 ounces. So I don't think that this baby's going to be that big. I mean, that small. But I guess you never know. So these are all 0 to 3 months. And this one's cool because it's all magnetic, so you don't have to deal with buttons. I don't know. Just a lot of cute little onesies. And these are tiny. I don't know if those will ever fit him. Cute little joggers. These are 2 to 4 months, or anything that just says like 3 months on it. And then 3 to 6 months, I believe. Yeah. Like, I don't know. It's hard because H&M, if you get any of your clothes, like baby's clothes from H&M, they're all like even months. So you can see here, like this one's 4 to 6 months. Whereas most clothes in America are like 3 to 6. So I don't know, they just overlap. So I guess this is like somewhere in there. I don't know. What? So yeah, 6 months, 4 to 6 months, somewhere in there. It's hard to figure out, like, they aren't all the same kind of size. This is mainly like 6 to 9 months in here. 6 to 12 months, I think there are a couple in here. Yeah, this cute little onesie. And then this was 9 to 12 months. So it doesn't have many things in this pile. And then 12 to 18, obviously, like, it's hard once they get, like, once you're pushing them this way, because you have no idea, like, what size they're going to be and, like, what the weather's going to be like. He has a cute little beanie. And then these were all, like, the bigger sizes, like, 18 to 24 months or, like, 2 years. So, yeah, those are all the clothes I have right now. We're having a virtual baby shower in 2 weeks from Saturday. So it sucks that we can't have, like, normal in person, but we'll do this, and then after he's here and after all of, like, this whole lockdown loveliness, we'll do, like, a little sip and see where you can come hang out. Like, don't bring gifts or anything, but just, like, meet my baby. Don't touch him. That's why it's called a sip and see. So yeah, just went through all of that, and now I'm going to probably work out in a little bit, and then I'll check back in. So I came to the condo to check on this one. He's pretty much done painting. He's been painting for, like, I don't know, 21 days straight or something stupid like that.
Has it been that long?
Something. It's been a long time. So yeah, I figured I would take them, show them what we're working with. Maybe they'll find your screw up.
Oh,
like,
great.
I did.
Do it. Do it. Get to it, lady.
So all the walls pretty much are this, like, off-white color. They almost blend in with his skin tone.
Are they pink enough?
And then all the baseboards and the trim are now white. So you can see there, it's all white. They were, like, a dark brown, ugly.
Very dark brown.
That still needs to be painted underneath there, but the shelves white. And then all the doors are now black. You know, nice and chic. So then we're still in the dilemma of what to do here. I think we agreed we were just gonna get, like, new black hinges because they're all, like, a weird gray brown. And I think it makes more sense instead of just painting them to get new ones. So this is our room. Tan. Just, like, simple. And then we haven't painted the bathrooms yet because we wanted, that is awful. Whoever cleaned that before we moved in, you can, like, see. We're gonna paint this bathroom and the other bathroom, like, a charcoaly black almost, but it's not. And then this is the baby's room. He still has to paint. He's gonna paint till, like, there black, and then we're gonna wainscot, however you people say it, right here. And then his crib is gonna go there, which is that. And then we'll have a black dresser, changing table, either a chair, like a rocking chair there, or, like, shelves. And if the shelves don't go there, then they'll probably go, like, right there. And then a rug. We need a big area rug. We need different curtains because those are awful. Mm-hmm. And then his closet, his bathroom. And then this will get painted too eventually. We'll move in before, like, this bathroom gets painted. And then this is going to get painted as well. White, because I'm not a fan of the brushed gold at all. And then our kitchen, we didn't do anything with the kitchen. We are gonna turn this closet right here, which is, like, you know, your catch-all coat closet. We're gonna turn that into our pantry because Justin's 220 pounds and that right there doesn't store enough food.
Used to be 235.
And then also look at, I don't know, this freezer is so tiny. Like, hi, we have chicken, we have waffles, vegetables, and that's it. Thanks for painting it all.
Of course.
So, I just got home from our condo because I'm hungry. But I thought I'd give a bump date. I don't know. I mean, feeling large. Things still, like, kind of fit. Like, obviously this shirt, these shorts still fit, but they were, like, they used to be a lot baggier. So it's letting me know that I'm swelling a little bit. My ring still fits. So yeah, he likes to take after his father and move around at 11 p.m., 3 a.m., 4 a.m. He just, he's like, yeah, let's party. This is fun. Me, on the other hand, I'm like, please, go to sleep. You'll know that, like, I've had a ridiculously pretty easy pregnancy, except for the fact that I can't think. And the one thing that I've noticed with this whole stay-at-home order is, like, with my skin, I don't know if it's because I haven't been wearing makeup as often or if in the third trimester, like, your skin texture just changes ridiculously. It feels like leather. Like, and the ends of my hair, if I'm not like really conscious with them, they feel like straw. So that's fun. Let's hope that the hormones will balance themselves back out and we'll go back the other way. And also another thing that I've had since pretty much, I don't know, like 20 weeks, I would say, is I have like such bad sciatic pain, but it's not really when I sit down, which is normally when it happens. My doctor let me know like it's normal, whatever, but man, it's like when he's pushing on my pelvis in the back, like right above my right butt cheek, and it like shoots down and it's just gotten increasingly worse because he's getting bigger. So yeah, I mean, I'm looking at all this as like a really big blessing because I'm just as tired now as I was during the first trimester, except you're bigger and it's more uncomfortable. So this is all like really cool because it's, I get to work from home right now, and I'm not sure how many people get that blessing of getting their third trimester of their pregnancy and getting to be at home. So I'm gonna take it. Obviously, we're not in like the happiest of times, but you gotta try and find the light in every single situation. I'm sure that everybody keeps saying that and whatever, but it's like, it's real. You go on Facebook or you go on Instagram and it's people spewing their opinion, which everyone's entitled to, but it definitely gets in your head and all the fear that's circling. And then you turn on the news and it's, the world is ending, we're all dying. I'm like, this is gonna be over. We'll all make it through. So I'm just curious, like, who else is pregnant during this time? Because it's, like, it's a weird time to be pregnant. And I'm just hoping and praying that Justin's able to be in that room with me. Like, please, please. And when you're due, and if all this is freaking you out, if you've recently had a baby, was your significant other able to be in the room with you? Just curious. Let me know down below, because it's nice to know you're not alone and that your feelings are valid. So yeah, that's pretty much what I do. And then I watch Grey's Anatomy. But I think I'm gonna end the video here now that I have nothing to do, and I'm probably just gonna watch said show. So if you enjoy me, if you enjoyed Justin, who was not really here, but here, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe down below. I think our next video, we're gonna do the baby mama dance if I can convince Justin. I'm trying, I'm really trying. So yeah, and we will forever love you. This is usually where I say bye, Justin. Like, tell Justin to say bye, Justin. He says bye, Justin, but he's not here, so bye, Justin.